Evan, I see you're drinking coffee. Is that a good brew?
Let me tell you what good brew is. Let me tell you about AWS Glue DataBrew. Did you know that companies spend as much as 80% time to prepare data? Data preparation is time-consuming, it is expensive, and it is a very much manual process. My name is Evan Janic.
And my name is Alina Yunus. In this video, we will introduce you to the basics of AWS Glue DataBrew. We'll talk about what DataBrew is, its core components, and then focus on its data lineage feature. At the end, we will also present a hands-on demo. So let's get started.
AWS Glue DataBrew is a serverless visual data preparation tool that makes it easy for data analysts and data scientists to prepare data with an interactive visual interface without writing code. With DataBrew, you can easily visualize, clean, and normalize terabytes and even petabytes of data directly from your data lake, data warehouses, and databases. With AWS Glue DataBrew, you can get data from various data sources, like Amazon S3. You can get it from relational databases, like Amazon RDS, your local files, like CSV, or from AWS Glue Data Catalog map sources. For input data, AWS Glue DataBrew supports commonly used file formats, such as CSV, JSON, Apache Parquet, and Excel sheets. Once you import data into AWS Glue DataBrew, you can explore, understand your data, and then transform it as you wish. The interactive data preparation workspace in DataBrew is called Project. Within a project, you can group multiple transformations together, save them as recipe. And then apply the recipes directly to the newly incoming data. You can choose from over 250 built-in transformations to combine, pivot, and transpose data without writing code. For complex transformations, DataBrew provides advanced machine learning techniques such as NLP, natural language processing. After that, you can run the job to transform the data according to the recipe script you just built. And then you can output the data to the location of your wish. That could be machine learning model. It could be S3 bucket. It could even be Amazon QuickSight to make great dashboards for your customers. For output data, AWS Glue DataBrew supports CSV values, JSON, Apache Parquet, Apache Avro, and Apache Arc.
Now on to data lineage. DataBrew tracks your data in a visual interface to determine its origin, called data lineage. This view shows you how the data flows through different entities from where it originally came. You can see its origin, other entities it was influenced by, what happened to it over time, and then where it was stored. This allows for data analysts to capture the relationship between the different data sources, how data gets transformed, converged, its upstream dependencies, and its downstream usage. Moreover, it allows to trace incorrect sources of error. All right, now that we've gone over the basic concepts of Glue DataBrew and data lineage, we'll now move over to a demo to see how this works in practice. For the purpose of this demo, we have a fictional retail company called Octatank. Octatank sells pet products online. They want to find out which product is not in demand in which area and target them to increase awareness and product sales. The data analysts team is fairly new. They want tooling that doesn't require them to code and manage infra. Additionally, they want to be able to track data flow so that it is easy to trace errors along the pipeline. Let's take a look at how Octatank can use Glue DataBrew to identify zip codes where specific products are not faring well. We have three kinds of data sets: the sales data set in Amazon S3, this contains information about the product that was sold, the quantity of the product, as well as the customer who bought it. The other two datasets are customer and product datasets. The customer dataset is residing in Amazon RDS, Relational Database Service. We have it extracted as a Glue data catalog table, which acts as a metadata table containing references to the data in RDS. Finally, we have the product data that exists as a CSV file on our local machine. We'll be joining and transforming all of these in Glue DataBrew. And then finally outputting them to an S3 bucket. Now let's move on to the demo. In the services search bar, type DataBrew, click on AWS Glue DataBrew, and this will take you to its console. On your left side, you have all the components we discussed earlier. Click on Create Project and give it a meaningful name. A recipe, as you can see, is automatically created. Now let's move on and create a new data set. Give it a name. This will be the data set that will correspond to the sales data set. And within it, we have the cs.csv file. Keep the rest as default and scroll down to permissions. Select the appropriate role and click on Create Project. Now you can visualize all the different columns of the data set. Let's take a look at the Data Lineage tab on the top right. Here we can see that cs.csv was loaded as a data set from S3. It is part of a project which has a recipe attached to it. We will populate this in a bit. Switching over to the cloud trail view, we can also see an audit trail of the different actions that were performed on a resource, the time at which they took place, and the user that performed them. In order to develop a recipe, let's head back to the project view. The next step is to join customer data with the sales data set. Click on Join on the top menu, and you will be now able to create a data set from the Glue data catalog for customer data. Give it a name. Select Data Catalog RDS Tables, and then click on OctaTank Customer DB and select Customer Table. Click on Create Dataset. Click on Next. Next again. From this screen, select Customer ID and also Customer ID from Table B and create an inner join while only selecting ZIP from the Table B. Click on Finish. Now we have to create another join with product data. We will achieve that by repeating similar steps as before, starting off by creating a new dataset and giving it a name. Selecting CSV upload as an option, then storing it in an S3 destination. Click on Create Dataset. Here you can preview the data. For the columns to join on, this time we will select Product ID and Product Key. So we select those here. And this time from the product table, we only select product type. Now OctaTank has all the data they need to calculate total sales by zip and product type. As the penultimate step, we'll remove all the unnecessary columns like TXN or transaction number, customer ID, and quantity. To finish off the recipe, we need to identify total sales by product ID, zip, and product type. For that, we create a grouping. So now we choose product ID, zip, product type, and total sales as the column names and choose aggregate functions. For total sales, the aggregate function would be sum. Click on Finish. Now that we have all the steps in our recipe, we will go ahead and publish this version. After publishing the version, we will run a job on it, which will apply the whole recipe to the entire data set in persisting the transform data. So in order to do that, let's create a job. We will give it a name. You need to provide an output location for the job, and for that we can select an S3 destination here. Select a role from the role name dropdown. And then finally create and run job. After the job is run successfully, we can take a look at the data flow and see how the lineage has changed. with more datasets and a destination being added. Note that this is the lineage for this project, and similarly, you can look at lineage for each one of the datasets as well.
Now where we understood what DataBrew is and what it can do, let's see where it fits. Customer asked me, Ermin, we have so many services in AWS. We already have AWS Glue Studio. We have SageMaker Data Wrangler. Now you come to me with AWS Glue DataBrew. What is the right tool for the job? So let's look at this small diagram to help you here. If you're focusing more on running ETL jobs, ongoing moving data between various data sources, you should use AWS Glue or Glue Studio. This is something your data engineers are going to use. If you're preparing data for machine learning and you would like to explore data, then use SageMaker Data Wrangler. This is something your data scientists are going to use. But for your data analysts who are there to explore, understand, and prepare data for reporting, use AWS Glue DataBrew. Of course, there is an overlapping scenarios where you can use different tools to accomplish the same tasks. For example, data transformation, you can use Glue Studio and DataBrew. For data exploration, you can use both DataBrew or Data Wrangler. I hope this diagram helps you to select the right tool for the job.
Cool. Let's summarize now. We discussed Glue DataBrew and looked at its data lineage feature in detail. In the demo, we saw how Octatank's data science team can use this to have a no-code tool to perform analysis while keeping track of the lineage. So that's it from our side. Now it's time for you to try it out on your own. Trust me, it's going to stick like glue. Bye-bye. Bye.